The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the multitudes of people, he went up on the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples gathered around him. He opened his mouth and began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek and lowly, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for justice, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are those who have been persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to them. Blessed are you when people insult you and persecute you, and falsely utter all kinds of evil against you on account of me. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for your reward is in heaven." My sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Wow. And can you imagine that? You know how people kept warm? They had to build a fire with wood, and that's how they kept warm. And they used those fires for cooking also. And they used candles for light at night, because you couldn't just pull a switch. It was a very different
world. It's Aaron's birthday. We offered eat up bottom made of our hands.
Well, that's a pretty, pretty good.
Well, anyway, let's talk a little more about. Well, let us have the story and then we'll talk some more, okay? Because the big people are listening to the story too. You know how they got around in those days? They rode horses or they walked everywhere. So when Francis was a young man, he thought he might like to become a knight in shining armor to fight the war that was coming on between the Christians and the Muslims. This was a time of real dungeons and dragons. And knights imagining themselves rescuing beautiful girls like you. And the goal was to take back the land that the Muslims took. Christians wanted to run the Muslims out of Jerusalem, the holy city. And at that time, it was the holy city for the Muslims too. So there were big fights over there. And Francis' dad probably liked that. He was a rich man who sold a car, and he went and got himself all the things to make his son a knight. He got him a horse, and he got him armor for his body, and probably the flags and everything, so that Francis could go out and fight in the war. Ooh, yes. You know, and sometimes our parents have a big idea about what we should do when we grow up. But sometimes we have to be the ones who step up and say, no, that's not quite right. I'm going to do something a little different. When I was young, my parents wanted me to go into business and run a store. And that's a good job. But, you know, I thought I would be bored to death. I didn't think I would like that. So I had to go a different direction in my life. And Francis had to go a different direction in his life. And someday, you may have to go a different direction in your life. After a while, my parents realized that I made the right choice for me. Well, Francis chose to follow Jesus, and he made an important decision. Instead of fighting, Francis and his friends decided to go to Egypt and see the Sultan of Egypt, who was head of all the Muslims, and to try to make peace with them instead of fighting. But he really hoped to convince the Sultan to follow Jesus. But that didn't happen. The Sultan didn't follow Jesus. He's still following Muhammad, his prophet. But Francis and the Sultan became very good friends. And even to this day, around the world, the people that followed Francis are good friends with the Muslims. So they gave us a good path to follow. When Francis was young, he thought he heard Jesus say to him, I want you to be my knight. And at first he thought that meant fighting in the war. But Jesus really wanted him to be his knight, his champion out in the world to make peace and to care for others. So eventually, Francis understood that. And he was not a priest. He was an ordinary man who went out and preached the gospel to people. Do you know what the gospel is? The gospel is good news. Good news about Jesus. And it's not just for priests to say, it's for all of us to say. When we are preaching the gospel, we're telling the good news of Jesus. So that is the news, that we should love one another and appreciate one another, even if we're different. So So Francis' father was rich, but he gave up all that money and went to live a very simple life. He was a hermit. Do you know what a hermit is? A hermit is a guy who lives off the land, very simple, doesn't have money, he doesn't even have a house, he didn't have a cell phone or a radio, and he would not be wearing Nikes or fashionable clothes. He would just be wearing one item of clothing. It was a simple robe. And to this day, the Franciscans wear those brown robes to follow Francis, even 800 years later. So he decided that to give up the money and follow Jesus. Now, that doesn't mean money isn't important. It's how we use it that counts. And that's why Jesus talked so much about money being a big problem for a lot of people. It's a big problem if we don't share. So Francis told us that. And Jesus came to Francis again. And he said, Francis, rebuild my church because you can see it is falling down. So at first Francis thought, well, the church building they were in was in very bad shape. It was falling down. It was made of stones, and it was falling down. And so they didn't have people taking care of the church building like we do today. We have good people here who, you know, for example, repainted your classroom and put new carpet on the floor and put up a big screen for us. But Francis has been trying to build these stones to build the church back. And the people in the village thought he was crazy, absolutely crazy, trying to build those stones back up. But eventually, Francis understood that wasn't the job Jesus gave him to do. Jesus gave him the job to rebuild the people of the church, to help them come together and to serve God and other people. The people are the church, not the building. Today, you are the church. Each one of you, you're the church. And these people out here, they're the church. It's not a building. It's not a place. It's in your heart. And you're hearing it as a part of Jesus' church. So when we come together to worship each Sunday, we share Jesus' love with one another. So he came to understand we allow Jesus to teach us. And we will eventually understand better what Jesus is telling us. Just like Francis did, he figured out it wasn't the rocks Jesus was talking about. It was the people inside the church. And Scripture tells us when we are children, we think as children. And when we grow up, we have a deeper understanding. But you have made a really good start by being here today and being part of the church. And we need each one of you to help us be a better church, to all be together. And Francis also preached love for every creature in the world we live in, the animals as his friends. So today we bring our puppies and kitties and turtles and whatever animals we have, and we bless them. And we do that. Jesus would have us take care of our world, and we are its guardians. We take care of our animals. Our job is to take care of the earth. So when we use energy well, when we don't waste food, we clean our homes and our streets, we recycle metal and paper, we're taking care of the earth. And we take care of the poor by not saving everything for ourselves, but sharing. Like the man in the Bible who built bigger barns to hold all his crops, instead of giving some of it away to the poor. And this is why you bring food to the altar each week, because you're bringing it to give to those who don't have any, who don't have enough. And you bless it. You stand there with the deacon, and you bless the food, just as St. Francis did. So we honor him and what he did. And we hope some of you someday will figure out what your vocation is. Do you know what a vocation is? A vocation is the work we do in the world. And it could be anything. It could be working as a secretary. It could be a carpenter. You know what Deacon Michael did before he was a deacon? He was a chemist. You know what a chemist does? He's in a laboratory and working with chemicals and doing important jobs. So as a chemist, that was his vocation. And he also has a vocation of deacon. Do you know what Mother Getty's job was before? She had the most exciting job. She managed a big toy store. Can you imagine what a good job that was? So, and she's a priest, and she had that job too. And we hope someday you will find what your vocation is. It could be a number of things. And we hope some of you girls and boys will become deacons and priests someday. Because you know why? Because we're getting old. And we need you to take over. You know that? You guys have got to grow up. We've got to grow some more deacons and priests, girls and boys. So Francis called to his vocation to love the animals, the earth, and to teach us to make friends with others who are different than us. And how can we make friends with others who are different? When kids are bullied on the playground, you can say, no, no, that's not a good thing to do. And you can make friends with the kids that everybody stays away from and help those kids out. And so you can bring food to the altar, and you can begin to help us build a better church, just like Francis did. He followed his path when the Lord said, rebuild my church. He didn't mean the rocks. He meant the people. And that is the gospel for today.
Amen.